Hi, this is Usha Rani from Bangalore. I completed my graduation and post-graduation from the Agricultural College of Tirupati that comes under the Acharya N.G. Ranga Agricultural University. And I recently completed my PhD from the University of Horticultural Sciences, Bagalkot, that is in Karnataka. And coming to my professional experience, after my graduation, because of some personal reasons, I didn't go for the post-graduation for 1 year. In that gap, I worked as a biology teacher for 6th standard to 10th standard children. And after my post-graduation, I worked as a horticultural officer for 1.5 years. This is my professional experience. And coming to the lesson I have taken now is circulatory system. Before going to take system, let me share my screen. Circulatory system. The both the human beings and the animals, both they need food and oxygen to keep themselves alive. Simultaneously, the body releases the carbon dioxide and other metabolic wastes, which are very harmful to the body. So the transport of nutrients and oxygen to the body, simultaneous removal of carbon dioxide and metabolic wastes is carried out through blood by a transport system called as a circulatory system. The main parts in the circulatory system are the veins, arteries, and then heart. Let me explain the main difference between the veins and arteries. The veins are the blood vessels which collect the deoxygenated blood from the all the body parts towards the heart. Among the veins, except the pulmonary vein, which collect the blood, oxygenated blood from the lungs to the heart. And the arteries are the blood vessels which transport blood from the heart to all the other body parts and except the pulmonary artery, which carries deoxygenated blood from the heart towards the lungs. This is the main difference between the arteries and veins. Then coming to the heart. Heart is usually the fist size of one cells. And this is covered by the double layered membrane. And the space between the two membranes is filled with the pericardial fluid. This fluid protects the heart from the shocks and jets. This heart is divided into right portion and left portion with the help of a septum, vertical septum. And these right and left portions are divided horizontally, the upper atrium and the lower ventricle. This the right atrium and opens into the right ventricle through a opening. That opening is guarded by the three walls. That's why this is called as a tricuspid wall. Similarly, the left atrium opens into the left ventricle through an opening that is guarded by the two walls called as a bicuspid wall. This ventricle, then it opens into the pulmonary artery. This left ventricle opens into the aorta. This aorta is the biggest blood vessel in the body. Again, this opening is guarded by the half moon shaped walls. That's why these are called as the semilunar walls. The main purpose of the all the walls is to prevent the backflow of blood. Okay. Next, coming to the, these are the walls. These are the tricuspid wall. And these are the bicuspid walls. And these are the semilunar walls. Then coming to the circulation. Once this right atrium receives the deoxygenated blood, and this one passes to the right ventricle through this wall, and the simultaneously the left atrium receives the oxygenated blood and this blood is passes through the left ventricle. Once these ventricles are filled with the blood, these walls are closes with a sound. Then from these ventricles, the right ventricle, the blood passes towards the pulmonary artery, and coming from the left ventricle, the blood passes towards the aorta. From this, the blood transport towards the all other body parts. This is the brief of circulatory system. Okay, thank you.